Hi, Miles and Martha Loss, your local real estate experts here. Today we're going to talk about how adding a bedroom or bedrooms can cause a reduction in value. Think about it. You would normally think that you've got a 3-2, you turn into a 4-2, that it would increase the value of the home. Yes, it can if done properly. If not done properly, it will actually reduce the value of the home. The technical term for this is called a functional obsolescence. And all that means is something with the home's functionality causes a reduction in value. And I'll give you an example of two ways that we've seen this. We've actually seen this in real life. For example, we have a second floor. You've got a bathroom and two bedrooms on the second floor, and you've got a living space. Somebody will come in and convert that living space into two additional bedrooms. So now you have four bedrooms and a bathroom on the second floor. Now think about how that will work. You've got 6 a.m. Monday morning, four bedrooms, four kids. They all have to go to school. They all get up at the same time. They all have to brush their teeth, take a shower, use the facilities, go to the bathroom, all at the same time. So you've got all these four unruly kids. You have problems. That's why it won't function. If you have that many bedrooms on a second floor, you would need at least one additional bathroom. So a conversion of that nature, when done properly, would have the addition of a bathroom, and it would be done with permits pulled, properly performed. The other way we see this is typically on the first floor, you would have somebody, same idea, they want to add a bedroom to try and increase the value. So you have a two bedroom, one bathroom home. They want to turn it into a three bedroom, one bathroom home. This is a one story home. So what they do is they go in and they convert either a porch, a dining room, or all of or a portion of a living room into an additional bedroom. So they go ahead and convert that. Here's the problem. When you have a bathroom, it's either right off the bedroom, such as a master bedroom, master bathroom, you just go right into the bathroom, or it's next to the room, or it's right down the hallway. But the important part of this is you don't have to walk through a common area to access a bathroom. You think about it. You wake up, your hair's all standing up, and you're in your pajamas or perhaps your underwear, and you step out, and the child's there, and the parents are having a party, or vice versa, and it's very awkward. It just doesn't make sense. So when you convert that living room, that porch, that dining room, you create that situation where you have to walk through common areas. You have to walk through the other portion of the living room. You have to walk through the kitchen, but you have to walk through common areas. The other one that I've seen only a couple times is where they put a bedroom on the other side of a bedroom, or they take a large bedroom and cut it in half. And then you have to, from the furthest bedroom, you have to walk through the other bedroom to get to the bathroom. That also is a functional obsolescence. The property doesn't function, it doesn't flow. You have to walk through the bedroom. So obviously there's something going on in the bedroom with somebody sleeping. It just simply doesn't work. But that's how adding a bedroom could cause a reduction of value of a home. Any questions, let us know.